Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die. And whoever lives by believing in me will never die. Do you believe this?"
"And if the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies through his spirit who lives in you."
"But he was wounded for our transgressions, he was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed."
These statements of hope stand as a testament to the mercy and saving grace found in the arms of our Father and Savior, Jesus Christ. This is our story, a modern tale of hope, written by a timeless author, the story of the blood.
My name is Eddie. I've been in the Lord for approximately 29 years, and it's been a wonderful life, and the blessings of the Lord have been upon my family. But before that time, I was a failure in everything that I did. The last 7 years of my first marriage, I became a drug addict, just casually using at work, and then eventually I got hooked on cocaine, and I was a heavy user. My nose would bleed, and I couldn't eat right, couldn't talk to anybody, just craved that narcotic. I was destined to go to hell, and I just didn't have any vision on what could happen to me as far as something good. Everything was just bad, going downhill.
My name is Helen. I have been serving the Lord for over 28 years. I was a Catholic going to church on Sunday and on special occasions. I had no real relationship with the Lord. I was always looking for peace and a feeling of acceptance. During my life before coming to the Lord, I had no self-confidence, a feeling that I didn't matter. No matter how much good I did, every day was a trial with no direction. People gave me no words to tell me how good I was in the things I did. Instead, nothing but negative comments. I thought that this was going to be my life forever. I married my husband, Eddie, and thought everything was going to be better. But he was using drugs for the first year of our marriage. I didn't know what to do.
My name's Kyle Sanborn. This is my story.
You can take my tribals.
It began earlier in 1992. I was born and raised in Baldwin Park. I went to Baldwin Park High School for 2 years. I grew up in the city. My life was fairly moderate for me. I didn't want for much. My father was a very good provider, and at the time he was. We didn't need for much because he did what he had to do to provide for us. Ultimately, drugs in particular, amphetamines, decided to take hold. When that happened, it was a downward spiral until 2008, where it ultimately culminated when we didn't have enough money to pay for a mortgage and we lost our house in Big Dalton. From there, we were in a motorhome for about, I want to say, a year, maybe at best. It was just parking lot after parking lot, going from Azusa to Glendora to all these other cities across the valley. And ultimately, it was that I was starting to lose hope. I started to lose hope for a long time, but I had to stay strong for my family. I had to be that pillar of strength for them. We were back and forth through motels after that, and when we finally lost our motorhome, we were street-borne for, I want to say, a few days. I was broken after that. I didn't know what else to do. I couldn't keep up my strength any longer. During that time, we were getting into a homeless shelter in Pasadena named Union Station. It was taking forever to get in because various reasons. My brother had a couple of things he needed to handle in the city. We couldn't get in because of that, and in spite of the fact that we had handled it, some of the shelters refused to help us any further. I ultimately threatened them with my life, and then we finally got the help that we needed.
My name is Jared Barbosa. When I was about 7 years old, the Lord healed me miraculously. At a church camp, my uncle was the director and my father was a preacher there. So we were in my uncle's camper hanging out, me and my cousins. We're all about the same age, about 7, 8 years old. And we were playing around, and I wanted to leave for whatever reason. And so as I was walking out, I'd open the door, and my cousin slammed the door on me. And my hand was still in the door. And if you know these old campers, it wasn't one of these little plastic things. It was a big, heavy metal door. And it slammed shut on my fingers, smashing about 3 or 4 of my fingers in my right hand. And then it got stuck. The door was stuck. We couldn't open it. And I was hysterical. All the cousins were freaking out. Some of them were laughing. And so I was freaking out. So finally, I guess some adults heard, and they came rushing over. And one of the brothers who was there at the camp, Brother Lopez, he just ripped the door clear off the hinges, and it was amazing. Actually, that was a miracle in itself. He ripped the door clear off the hinges, and there I was with my busted up fingers. So they took me to the infirmary, which wasn't too far away, and Brother Ruben, who's a minister here at our church still, Brother Baron, he laid his hands on my hands and he prayed for them. And then, those things were mangled, just all crooked. I mean, it wasn't just a slight fracture. No, these little 7-year-old boy hands were crushed.
Oh, Jesus, alive in me.
So then, this is my story. My name's Alfred Miramontes. I've been serving the Lord for the last 17 years. God has been very gracious to us. Gotten married in those 17 years. Have 3 wonderful children. God has done a lot of wonderful things. He's blessed us with His Spirit, given us great peace. Things that I didn't always understand, things that I didn't always know in my life. Maybe like a lot of us, or maybe not so many, but at the age of 13, I hung out with the older kids, and they introduced us into drugs and pornography and all the really weird things that you don't ever hope to get trapped in, but... It progressed from the age of 13. I mostly would, drink on the weekends, steal beers from my parents and whatnot. And the older kids had marijuana cigarettes, and we'd get loaded on the weekends. Well, as time progressed and as things went, we moved away from San Gabriel, summer of 84. We went to Fontana, where things really got crazy. A lot of methamphetamine, cocaine, you name it. Pretty much everything was available. At the age of 16 to about 18, 17, I was still kind of daily, but not so hardcore. But about 18 to 23, I basically would say that I was loaded every single day until the age of 23, you name it, from every kind of drugs and alcohol. I thank God that around, I guess, the summer of my 23rd birthday, I thank God I had a heart attack. I say it now because it was able to open my eyes and to realize that there was something missing in my life, and God began to deal with me. And really, it was the most awesome thing. See, we went to a youth service one time, and in this youth service, I detoxed there. I mean, if anyone knows anything about detoxing, it's really painful, and it's a long process. But because God is gracious and merciful, He was able to detox me all in one service.
I just asked the Lord to help me. He just turned me around and made a new life. It's like I should have been dead. Anything that happens is great. By the mercy of God, am I here? And I thank God for that.
The Lord immediately began to change my life. I felt a love and peace I never had before. I began to be a person that lived by God's laws to the best of my ability. The Lord, He is my guide. When problems arise, He is my strength. He is my Savior. Today, my husband, myself, my son Steve, David, and Philip all attend and participate in church.
Brother Ruben laid his hands on my hand and just prayed for it in Jesus' name. And then miraculously, right there in front of everybody's eyes, my fingers, they just went straight, you know, from broken to straight in a matter of seconds. God's miraculous healing just right then and there. Because the Lord healed me and healed my hand, I've been able to play guitar. And through playing guitar, God's opened up just tons of doors for ministry and opportunities that I wouldn't have had otherwise. And it makes me really grateful to God.
Now I'm 19 years old, and God has given me a home. He's given me food to eat and a place to sleep at night. My sins are now forgiven, and I don't have to follow that road of destruction and chaos that the world has. I chose to follow His road, the road of direction and purpose, the result of which I am now a soldier in the United States Army.
Because of His blood, I am saved.
Because of His blood, I am saved.
Because of His blood, I am saved.
And because of His blood, I am victorious. Because of His blood, I am set free, and I am no longer bound. I am victorious in Jesus Christ.
Tried to keep. Now you're on your knees. You're on your